Hi everyone, welcome you all. In this video, I'm going to discuss about random controller and random order controller. So let's start with the random controller. So I'm opening my JMeter. So currently I have one thread group under test plan. So the thread group contains four different samplers or requests. One is admin login request, then user login request, and then flight booking and registration. So when I run all these three requests, so here I already added one report called view result report. So I'm just clearing this and I'm executing my request, and then I can see all the requests have sent successfully: admin login, user login, flight booking and registration. So now my requirement here is, so flight booking and registration, these are the main functionality I want to test. But before that, I need to use one login, either admin login or user login. So randomly, I need to pick up one of these login, either admin login request or user login request. So normally when I execute this group, what happens is all the requests will send to the server and execute it. Suppose I want to choose one of these login. So then you need to go for random controller. So let me just show you how we can add. So I'm just adding right click new. So logic controller, and here I'm taking random controller. So once we added this random controller, I'm just drag and drop this admin user, admin login, and then user login. So now under random controller, I have added two requests, admin login and user login. So now what happens is when I execute my request, flight booking registration will always execute same order, but admin login and user login, so it will execute only one of them at a time. So it will pick up admin login or user login randomly. So that is all about random controller. Let's execute and see that. So I'm just clearing the result. Currently view result, it doesn't have anything. So let me execute this. So when I execute, once I have executed, so now it is executed flight booking and then registration and then admin login, user login. So one of them is taken. So this time we have executed admin login, right? So for example, let me execute one more time. So this time again, it is captured admin login. So we need to run multiple times like this. Randomly, it will pick up either admin login and user login. So let me run one more time. And this time you can see it is taken user login, right? Flight booking, registration, user login. So what is random controller means, it will execute one request at a time, depend randomly. So either admin login or user login. You can have any number of requests under this as a chain in the under random controller, but at a time it will take only one chain and will execute randomly. So that is all about random controller. So let me execute one more time. I'm clearing this. Every time when you execute this, every time it will take a different type. So now again, this time it is taken admin login, and again clearing these results one more time, and this time it is taking again admin login, clear, and again run it. So this time again is taking admin login. So sometimes randomly it will pick up user login. So now we can see it is taken user login. So this is how we need to use random controller. Now the next one is random order controller. So random order controller is slightly different than random controller. Now I'll show you how to use this random order controller. So again, let's go to JMeter. So currently random controller, let it be there. Now what I will do is, so currently flight booking and registration is there. So I'm just creating one simple, simple controller. Go to logic controller. I'm just creating one simple controller. Simple controller is a container which can have multiple requests, right? So I'm just moving flight booking every request under simple controller and registration, everything. So simple controller contains flight booking and registration, and as well as admin login and also user login, everything. So now I'm just disabling my random controller. I don't require for now. I'm just disabling this. Fine. So now observe this. So now I'll put all the requests under a simple controller. It's user login, then admin login, flight booking, and registration. Now let's clear and save, execute. So now if you notice, all the requests have executed sequentially, like user login, admin login, flight booking, and registration. And whichever order we specified these requests under simple controller, and the same order, the requests have been executed. Suppose I'll put registration first, and then flight booking next, and user login and admin login. So again, clear the result and execute. This time, again, it will follow the same order. So registration first and flight booking, user login and admin login. So now what I want to do is, here my requirement is, I want to execute all the requests without missing any one request, but I want to execute them random order. But I want to execute all the requests in random order. But in simpler controller, it is not possible. So by default, whichever way order we specified here of the same order, it will be executed. But if you want to execute all this request in random order, then we go for random order controller. So now I'm creating another controller, add logic controller and random order controller. So under random order controller, I am just moving everything under random order controller, flight booking, user login, and then admin login. So even simple controller also, I'm just disabling this. Now disable means these two will not execute at the runtime. Now I have added random order controller. So under random order controller, I mentioned all the requests. So admin login, user login, registration, flight booking, right? Now save it and then execute it. So once we have executed, now we can see here in which order these requests have executed. So first admin is executed, then user login executed. Now we can see these two are jumbled. So first flight booking is executed and then registration is executed. So what does it mean is random order controller will execute all the requests in random order. Okay, so this time it is executed admin user login, then flight and registration. Now, when I execute again, this time it may be changed. So now this time it is executed admin user login and for both are same order. Now registration, flight booking, again, same order it is followed this time. So again, execute this one multiple times. We have to see. So execute. Now admin login is executed. Now we can see the order is changed. Admin login is executed, then flight booking, user login and registration. So random order controller will execute multiple sampler requests in random order. In random order. So if you have a requirement like this, you can just use random order controller. Now that is all about random order controller. So now we will differentiate what is difference between random controller and random order controller. So in the random controller, if you have a multiple request, it will choose only one request at a time. Randomly, it will execute only one request in random controller. When you come to random order controller, it will execute all the requests. It will execute all the requests in random order. It will not miss any even one order. So it will execute all the requests in random order. But in case of random controller, it will execute only one request. That request also will pick up randomly. So that's the basic difference between random controller and random order controller. So that's all for this video, guys. So thanks for watching.